And good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us, Don. I'd like to introduce everyone to Gábor Macher from Macher Electronic and Engineering Limited, all the way from Hungary. How are you doing, Gábor?
Thanks, I'm doing great, and I welcome you all here. And you might be wondering why a guy in a suit and a tie is standing in at a stage for startups. And I can tell you the reason. You have seen in the previous video was what Max was doing. So imagine yourself as a startupper going through the struggle that you have your first order. You are a hardware startup and you have your first order. You made a prototype, it works fine. Somebody just bought, let's say, 10,000 pieces of it, and you don't have a heck of an idea how to deliver it. And this is why I'm here. I'm trying to help startups scale up in the hardware field as well. For startups, sometimes, as I feel, it seems really easy to develop something, and it's really easy to develop a program. But when it comes to series production, and series production in a manner, in a fashion, which makes it viable for 1,000 pieces or 10,000 pieces, that's where hardships are coming. And for startups, the first 100 pieces, which is delivered to the first customers, this is one of the most important, one of the key things to deliver. Because if you fail to deliver on time, if you fail to deliver on quality in the first 100 pieces, 1,000 pieces, then you might be risking the whole company. And this is where my company can help. We started as a startup. It was 33 years ago, and it was started with my parents. They didn't have any job because there was a system change in Hungary. And they founded a company which started to work for different electrical manufacturing companies, bigger companies. And as I took over, through the years, we started to develop connections towards startups as well, which means that we can help the startups in many different fields. And let me show you where. I'll just skip some of the presentation. So where can we help startups and where hardware startups needs to have some help? First of all, the idea. Of course, they have a basic idea, most of the hardware startups, what they want to do. Most of them know what the software has to do, what the software has to do, but sometimes they lack just the last 1% of what the hardware should do and how to develop and how to have an idea for a hardware that actually works in series production as well. Because it's really easy to manufacture one piece, but it's another thing to manufacture 1,000 pieces or 100,000 pieces. So we can help with the idea generation. And then the second step, as I mentioned, if you have the right idea, if you have, then you have to have the right development. You have to use the right materials, because sometimes the electrical engineers, the software development team, cannot really do the work of the hardware development as well. We have engineers to do so. And where we have these engineers from, where we have the pool for that, this is coming from the Hungarian economy. We have great universities where we can source these people. We have a strong infrastructure of laboratories and other kind of test centers where we can work together and we can help these companies to grow their product into a serious producible product. And then prototyping. So once we know what we want to do, once we know it's feasible to do it on a bigger scale as well, then we have to do the first prototypes. Doing a prototype for a hardware can be really tricky because you have to source, let's say, 100 different kinds of articles. You want to do it in a relatively low-cost manner because you don't want to risk a hell lot of money. And then you want to do the prototypes as well pretty fast, because as we usually experience, startup projects are usually a bit overdue, and where they want to speed up the process is actually the prototype production. And they always need the prototype pretty fast because they have a new exhibition, they have a new trade fair, they want to show the new product. So this is where we can help the startups, or not just us, but companies who are in connection with hardware startups, is that we have the capability of having in-house CNC machines, having in-house 3D printers to do these prototypes fast, because fast prototype production, especially for the startups, is key. If we can deliver, if we can't deliver the product in 2 weeks, it's already too late for them. If you don't have the 3D printers in-house, if you don't have the CNC machine in-house, it takes 4 weeks to get a quotation and another 4 weeks to get the product. It's just already too late. And then testing. What I mentioned at the really beginning of the presentation, once a startup reach a stage of scale-up, so they already have bigger amounts of orders, I'm talking about hardware startups again, they need to have tested pieces going out from the manufacturing hall, because they need to have the quality, they need to get the quality right. If the quality is not right, then the whole thing can come crashing down. And then testing is one of our biggest excellences. We can do special test equipments, special purpose-built test equipment, which will test that exact parameter of a hardware which needed to be tested, so we can make sure that everything that goes out of the factory is tested and will be at the best quality, and there will be no issues at the user. So the startup, so our customer will be happy, so the user will be happy, so we can go further with them. Tools and equipment. Of course, these, especially at the beginning, usually a startup, when it starts to scale up, requests just a couple thousand pieces at the beginning. And you need some special tooling for that. If you don't have the engineers, if you don't have the background, and we have 10 engineers working in that field, if you don't have the background, then you can't develop these special equipment and special tools which will make you able to produce these hardwares. Why it's important? Because the startups, by their nature, are usually working on something innovative. So you don't have off-the-shelf tools to manufacture them. You have to actually figure out a way how to manufacture them. This is where companies like us, who in a sense invest their engineering hours, their engineering capabilities into startups, can help these startups, hardware startups, to grow. And then bigger ones, once they reach a certain size, millions of pieces, maybe we can't follow them because we are mostly focused on mid to low to mid volume. Then they will go to other companies, bigger manufacturers, maybe in Hungary as well. And then once everything seems to be ready, then there is always a big boat turning sideways in the Suez Canal, and you can't have any raw material be available at your disposal. So you have to figure out a way how to source those materials in the supply chain. And from the outer world, it might seem to be pretty easy to do, to source material, but in real life, it's really challenging. Sometimes lead times can be 10 weeks, 16 weeks, 50 weeks, you know, more than a year and so. So you either have to figure out, okay, where can I get this special material from a supplier who has it on stock, or how can I replace it in a way that it will still be able to do the same thing, but it can be but it's available in 2 or 3 weeks time. And then once you have everything ready and then everything is up and running, you will have to have the series production. And this is where it comes to the question of soldering here live. Imagine doing the same thing thousands and thousands of times, and you have to get it right every time. Max might make a mistake of a short, but in our job we can't make that mistake, because each and everything has to be perfect, so the end product is perfect. And doing a prototype is completely different than doing series production, because with the prototypes you have the time, okay, not that much time, but you have time, you know there will be some issues, you can figure them out. But in the series production, when different people, blue collar workers, are doing these steps, you have to ensure that these colleagues can also do the steps in a way which makes it basically impossible to get it wrong. So you have to ensure that the production processes are so the quality processes are so that you can't produce a bad piece. Or if you could somehow produce a bad piece, you could actually catch it at the quality inspection and have another one made. And then basically that's maybe the least challenging one, but it can be the packaging. We have experienced sometimes that packaging can be challenging because the product has to be saved by the outer world. And you know, these big carriers, they not always care about your product. This is our experience. So you have to sometimes develop a packaging which enables the product to be delivered in a safe condition. So it doesn't just leave your factory or your warehouse in one piece, but it will arrive in one piece to the customer as well. So companies like us or like ours can help startups bring their ideas into reality, because in real life, hardware manufacturing and hardware development seems to be an easy case, but in real life, it's not that easy. Let me just go back. How we develop this ability. Throughout 33 years, we could step by step as a startup, maybe not in an exponential manner, but step by step develop our procurement team, develop our production team, develop our engineering team in such a manner that they can help other companies grow with their own products as well. What are the industries that we are serving with? We have industrial products, we have automotive products, we have aerospace products, medical products, and any different kinds of products like e-mobility, other startup products, other healthcare products, and so on and so forth. What we do is basically, as I mentioned, production and development. And how we do it, because where we do it is in a manufacturing hall, which is around 2,500 square meter. And what is important is that 500 square meter, which is specialized production area, this is humidity and temperature controlled. So you can actually have your products produced or manufactured in a humidity and temperature controlled environment. And as a last step, what is really important, as I mentioned, that your products will leave the manufacturing hall or leave the warehouse in a manner that it's usable by the customer, that the quality is the best. And how we reach that throughout the years is that step by step we developed a quality management system, which is basically step by step adding more and more features and adding more and more systems on top of each other until we reach the point right now. We started with the ISO, which is one of the most basic thing, and I would recommend every startup to go to a manufacturing place that has at least ISO 9001, because that ensures at least a basic level of quality. And then we have the AN 9100, which is the aerospace certification, so our products can go to the space as well, because every product that is, of course, the raw material has to be also in accordance with the AN specifications, but our manufacturing process is able to handle that. And also IATF, so automotive products, shouldn't be a problem. Of course, we have certain specific trained colleagues and areas like IPC. They also help with the quality of the product. Before the last slide, before basically our details, I just want to give a short wrap up of what to care about and how companies like us can help hardware startups. So basically, hardware development is not that easy as it seems at the first place. Second of all, serious production is not that easy as it seems at the first place. And getting it right every time is not that easy as it seems in the first place. And if a startup wanna make sure that the product that they wanna sell on a bigger scale, thousands of pieces or hundreds of pieces, not just one or two pieces that they put together at home, then they should, and I recommend, if not us, then somebody else, but I recommend to go to a manufacturing or a production place, an EMS manufacturer who has the knowledge of working together with startups, who has engineering background, who has a connection towards different areas of laboratories, different areas of test laboratories, so you can have your products at the best possible quality and on time. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, you can contact us anytime. Thank you.